Hello everyone and welcome to this BC in 3D webinar, focused on 3D printing using supports and support materials. I'm Álvaro García, Product Manager at BC in 3D. I'm working on the material strategy portfolio and today I will introduce you why support structures are so important.
Hello, I'm Jesse Wiggins, Applications Engineer at BC in 3D, and I will bring you some relevant cases where support structures have been the success key. So we are going to talk about why support structures are so important, and after this we will present you some examples. So please, Álvaro, why support structures are so important?
Let's start introducing FFF, or fused filament fabrication, a 3D printing technology where the object is built by depositing melted material layer by layer. Each new layer requires a layer underneath to support it. So this is why it's so important to print support structures. We are always going to try avoid support structures because they can be a waste of time and material. However, this webinar is about those cases where we don't have a choice but to use print supports. For instance, this is important to success when printing complex geometries, when printing features in midair, or when we want to reorient the part to get the best mechanical properties.
Let's see now in detail the main type of geometries that requires support structure. A good example would be the word BCN. We are going to start with the letter N, which is the easiest one, and whose geometry consists in vertical and slope walls. We call those walls overhang. Overhang means that each layer is supported by the layer by the previous layer. Each material can reach different overhang angles. As you can see in other examples that we have here, carbon fiber and glass fiber parts allows you to reach bigger overhang angles without compromising the surface quality. As you can see in the part, this overhang can be near 20 degrees and was reached without any kind of issue. The maximum values are defined by default in BCN 3D Cura, where the software will show you in red the areas that require superstructure. When printing overhang, support structures can also be applied to reach better surface quality. The second example would be the letter B, whose geometry consists of with what we call bridges. Bridges happen when you have an horizontal part of your model flying on a meter. You can use superstructures to achieve better surface quality, but also better dimensional accuracy. Some materials can fly more than others, so you have to take in mind always the material that you are using.
The third example is the letter C, whose geometry always requires support. There is nothing for the overhang to keep the material printed in place, and without support, this part will just fall down. We also want to mention that some materials fly longer without supports or achieve bigger overhangs. Based on our portfolio, we have set in order the materials based on the bridging or overhang capability. This capability depends on the material and the possibility of increasing the fan speed. As you've seen, we can use support materials in order to solve these tricky situations. Mainly, we are able to use two different options: build material supports and water-soluble supports. Let's start talking about generating supports with the same material as the main part. This option allows us to print main parts and supports with the same material for everything. This is the simplest way to do it, because we only use one extruder and one material. And when is creating supports with the same material a good solution? When we only want to use a single extruder mode, or if we only have a single extruder 3D printer? Another good example to use the same material will be wanting to use the mirror or duplication mode while also printing supports. Another common use for this type of supports is when printing PP or PPGF30. These filaments are not compatible with others, and support structures have to be printed with the same material.
Moving now a bit more into detail, let's take some print parts to show you better the pros and cons of this solution for printing support structures. As Alvaro said, we reduce the print time thanks to the time we save avoiding the tool change from one extruder to the other. Also, we are able to enable the duplication and mirror mode. For this concrete part, we set enough overhang angle to use support just for the main bridges, avoiding the excess of supporting other areas. So these are the main advantages. Let's see what are the main disadvantages. As you can see in the video, more post-processing work is needed. Also, there is a risk of damaging small parts removing supports. And last but not least, the poor surface quality. So, moving now to better solutions for supports.
Let's look now into the second option, soluble materials, which are water-soluble thermoplastics. One of the benefits of using IDEX technology is to be able to create complex geometries or trying to avoid geometric limitations. With soluble supports mode, we are able to print the main part with one filament and the support structure with the second. Water-soluble materials allows us to reorientate the part to get the best mechanical properties or get a better surface quality. Our first introduction was the PVA. It's a super well-known material that especially works with standard material and flat surfaces. In comparison with the PVA, our newest solution, BV08, extends the compatibility with most of the BCN 3D filaments. It's easier to remove and allows to achieve better surface quality with a faster dissolution.
So, in which cases do we recommend soluble support materials? Well, when you have to print complex geometries, hollow parts, or partial cavities. Here are some examples. In the case of this deposit, the supports would be impossible to remove manually if the support material was the same of the main part. In the case of this helmet, the surface finish of the button was an important requirement. As you can see, the surface finish is just perfect. Or, as Alvaro said, the mechanical properties. For this axis, we need to increase the section in order to obtain a better mechanical behavior. Also, you have to take in mind the compatibility between materials. So, PVA will be compatible with some of them, and BV08 with most of them. As we mentioned before, in comparison with PVA, BV08 extends the compatibility with a wider range of materials. Talking about compatibility, here are some examples. As we said, BV08 is compatible with ABS, polyamide, or composites, allowing the user manufacturing complex mechanisms or flexible parts made out of rigid materials. On the opposite way, we have the PVA. On the other hand, the lesser compatibility of the PVA can also be an advantage. As you can see, this sole was printed in TPU and PVA, allowing the user to remove the supports without solving them. But again, we recommend you to check the compatibility chart before setting your G-code.
We have been taking a look into the main applications of water-soluble materials. On the other hand, it's important to mention that a proper storage is vital for this kind of materials. Water-soluble materials absorb moisture from air. It is essential to avoid in order to not experiment printing issues. To achieve the best results, we have to store that kind of filaments in an airtight compartment. For that reason, at BCN3D, we have developed the smart cabinet, engineered to keep the optimal storage conditions for the filament and even to print without removing the spool from the compartment. For more information, visit bcn3d.com. Finally, we cannot forget the dissolution time. We have to keep in mind that this material dissolves without interaction, but it will take some time to be completely removed. Also, important to mention that BVOH dissolves 2 times faster than PVA, which can significantly accelerate your part production process.
We have discussed the main characteristics of soluble support materials. Now, we want to discuss an application that really showcases the utility of soluble materials, the fabrications of sacrificial molds for fiber manufacturing. Soluble materials brings the capability of solving internal molds that can be removed by any other method. This is particularly useful for aeronautic or motorsport industries, where complex parts are needed. PVA, for example, it's a commonly used release agent. Thanks to IDEX technology, you can print soluble interfaces and internal molds for this kind of applications. Cheap and fast.
This is all we want to discuss today regarding support materials. We hope that this webinar was useful and have solved some of your doubts regarding when using supports and which material can be the best one for your applications depending on the requirements and needs.
Don't hesitate to contact us if you have any further questions. For more information, please also check our knowledge base. Thanks for watching and happy 3D printing.